Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Jiang Smiles. I'm Chris and I'm a dental student from NUS. So today I'll be sharing with you my active recall framework that I use to study for my exams. So just a bit of sidetrack, back in year 2, I was taking modules such as pharmacology, pathology, dental materials and microbiology, and I actually ended up as the top student in the exam performance. So if you want to see my grades, do stick to the end of the video to find out. So just a bit of background information. In dentistry, we don't have a choice on what kind of modules we want to take. So there's no bidding involved, unlike in the other faculties where you have to bid for your modules. For us dental students, we basically go through the same academic curriculum. Also, the module tests and exams last throughout the entire year, not just the semester. Meaning, at the final exam, you are actually tested from things from back in Sem 1 and Sem 2 as well. And actually, most times, a lot of the foundational knowledge on these subjects are based upon the earlier years. So for instance, when we're taking pathology, we have to have a degree of understanding in year 1 subjects like anatomy, biochemistry and physiology. So I mainly credit my performance in the year 2 exams to this concept known as active recall and spaced repetition. And this method of active recall and spaced repetition should work for most subjects that require memorization or those kind of essay-based subjects like biology. I hope that you can pick up some tips and tricks from this video and apply it to your learning. My method consists of 3 main stages and you can see them right here. So the first stage is to convert your lecture notes into flashcards. I'll convert whatever lecture notes that I've been through today or learned today into flashcards. I've been using this app called Anki since year 1 of dental school. And Anki is basically an app that uses the concept of spaced repetition and active recall to aid learning. It can be downloaded for free on a computer, but if you're an Apple user, you have to pay for a one-time fee. It's also free on Android. Now take note, you shouldn't be doing these flashcards in a way whereby it's like one lecture note slide, one flashcard. Because I've done that previously in year 1, and I found that by the end of the semester, I'll end up with hundreds of cards that I do not end up finishing. So instead, what I would recommend is that you group your lecture slides and the content into sort of these content blocks. And also I recommend you to do this technique at the end of the week or immediately after your lecture so that the knowledge that you have regarding this subject is fresher. And while you're making these flashcards, you are actually indirectly reviewing the content you've learned today. So that's stage 1, conversion of your notes into flashcards. Stage number 2 is to practice active recall on these flashcards that you've made with spaced repetition. So fortunately, you don't really have to set a schedule on when you need to do a particular subject. Anki does it for you, so I just follow whatever Anki recommends. For me, I usually do it based on one subject, one day, so I don't really overload on the amount of content that I have in my head. So for instance, on a particular day, I might feel like studying this subject. I can simply go over to that group of folders of flashcards and study that subject. It is preferable that you do this active recall on a daily basis. And actually, this form of active recall learning strategy has been supported by evidence-based research. It is the most effective way of learning and memorizing content. And also, my principal from Temasek Junior College actually talked about this pretty often. It's known as the Ebbinghaus forgetting curve. And what this curve basically shows that each time you repeat the learning of a subject or the practice of a certain subject, you are actually improving your retention of the material. And that is the basis of active recall and spaced repetitions. Spaced repetition determines how often or how frequent you should learn that content, such that you remember this material and you will be able to perform well during the exam. Additionally, you can do it on snippets of time that you're available. So for instance, for me, I like to sometimes do Anki flashcards on the bus ride to school, when I'm queuing for food, in between sets of the gym. And lastly, most importantly, would be to do it a lot during the exam period. And now the third stage would be to prepare awesome essays and memorize them. So this is for the period when it's closer to your exams. So a lot like the 10-year series questions that we get from O-levels, A-levels, there may be certain past year questions from your school that you can take a look so that you have a rough sensing on what kind of questions they like to ask in the end of module examinations. And the objective of you is to, as much as possible, craft a perfect model answer towards that question. So what are the things that make an essay good? A lot of this applies to techniques that I've learned from general paper. So the PEEL format, PU format, link being the most important because oftentimes you need to link back to the question to show the examiner that you are answering to the question. And also there has to be a certain degree of critical thinking involved, much like in general paper. To display your critical thinking, you have to show a balanced perspective when it comes to answering the question. So the kind of content that you put into the essay can be from lecture notes, from textbooks, from Google, or from PubMed. A lot of times, making an essay good is really having a good plan ahead such that the structure of your essay can be easily followed. So now that you have crafted a series of essays, your objective is to upload this information into your brain through spaced repetition and active recall so that during the exam, you can regurgitate whatever you've learned or whatever you've memorized from the model essay. And if you're lucky, the examiner may repeat the question, of which you are just able to regurgitate whatever you've learned. But if it's a completely new question, it's also okay because you are able to have several content blocks that you've learned from various essays and combine them together such that you are able to form a cohesive and well-argued essay. In fact, that was similar to what happened to me during the exams in year 2, and that's how I managed to end up as the overall top student in terms of exam performance for that year. So here's my university transcript. Also, for those of you wondering, in dentistry we don't really have GPA or any bell curve. Most of us actually graduate with a normal degree. In fact, I think that in the entire history of NUS dentistry, less than 20 students have been awarded honors. Thank you for watching this video. If you've learned something new from this video, do help me out and leave a like and subscribe to my channel. Also, you can share with me your study tips and techniques in the comment section below. Thank you and see you again. Bye!